Abracadabra. Now, this is the most common magic phrase that you hear when any magician is showing some magic, right? But you know what? People who believe in science, like me and you, we don't believe in magic because we know that anything that looks like magical has either some science behind it or some tricks that magician is doing or maybe some mathematics. Do you know? If we can do some magic with mathematics or especially with geometry. So today I will tell you how to do some magic with geometry, and I will give you all the tools and templates to do that magic yourself, right? So let's learn the magic, and then in the description of this video, you can download that template to do this magic yourself, right? So let's begin. Okay, so let's start our magic, and you see that I have this special geometrical design on this paper, and I can start the magic. So let me cut these pieces, this big triangle, this is square and a rectangle. All right, so let me cut this. Now let me start showing you how to do magic with these. So we will start with the simple one, which is our rectangle here, all right? So you see, here is the rectangle. And now, in a rectangle, it's very easy. If you have to count number of squares which are there inside, how will you count? So you just multiply the height and width. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is the height, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, right? So 13 into 5, 65. So that means these pieces together should have 65 squares, right? Now let's do the magic. And to do the magic, let me do my own magic wand, abracadabra. I love science, okay? So now let's rearrange these pieces and see what is the magic in this, all right? So I will just rearrange same pieces so that the area of all the pieces combined should remain same, because we are not removing any pieces or not adding any pieces, but we have to do some magic within the same set of pieces, all right? Now, after we rearrange these pieces of this rectangle, now let's see what has happened, okay? So now we have this rectangle again. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So height is 5. And the width, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So 5 into 13, the width and height of this rectangle is still the same, but we see one extra square which has come from somewhere, right? Now that means this rectangle's area is actually 65 pieces plus one extra space. Now how did that magic happen? All right, so you have to solve this yourself and download this design from our website and then see. So let's do the same magic with this big design, with this triangular design, and let's see. In this triangle, the area is base into height divided by 2. And the base is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And the height is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay. Now let me rearrange these pieces into a special way. The same set of pieces without adding or removing any parts. I'm just rearranging these pieces and then see what happens. All right. Now you see, I have use same set of pieces. Let's see what is the area. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And the height is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That means the height and the base of this triangle is still the same, but we have got these two extra squares in between. Now, how did that magic happen? Right? So you have to find out the solution. Once you do this yourself, you will figure out what is the geometrical magic that we have in this, right? Now, I have one very simple and interesting magic for you here. And let's see, what do we have here? So, in this design, you can see that there are a few people, okay, in this design. Let's count how many people are there, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So there are 13 people in this design. Now let me do this magic again. Abracadabra, I love science, right? Now let's do this. The same pieces, if I just rearrange them, and then let's see what happens. Okay, now let's see how many people are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Now, how did this 13 become 12? Where did the 13th person go? Can you figure out? Now, that is the magic you have to figure out when you do this yourself. So, did you like the magic of our geometry? Next time, when any magician tries to fool you, remember, there is no magic. It's always either some tricks or some science or mathematics. Right? So next time, nobody should tell you abracadabra. Because there is no magic, it's always some trick or science or mathematics. Bye-bye.